In this tutorial, we will learn SolidWorks Surface Modeling Basics. Watch this complete tutorial to understand SolidWorks Surface Modeling concepts perfectly. To receive new video notifications every alternate Monday, Wednesday and Saturday, please subscribe to this channel and press the bell icon. Please also like and share this video. Let's start with this tutorial. Click here on New. Select Part. Click on OK. In this tutorial, we are not going to start from very basic level. So if you want to learn SolidWorks from very basic level, then link to complete playlist is given in description. Then to bring here surface toolbar, right click here, take your cursor to tabs and click here on surfaces. So here surfaces toolbar is added. Then first command we are going to learn is extruded surface. Click here on extruded surface. Then suppose I will choose this top plane. Then I will create some ellipse. If you want to learn about sketch in detail, then link to that complete playlist is also given in description. Click here on ellipse. Then click here on this origin point. Take your cursor away and click. Then take your cursor on this side and click. Then I will create one more ellipse. Again, click here on the center point, take your cursor away, click, then take your cursor on this side and click, then right click and click here on exit sketch. Then here you will have to specify depth, suppose it is 30, press enter. Then if you want to apply draft angle, then from here you can apply draft, just click on it, so it will get on. Then here you will have to specify draft angle. Suppose it is 10 degree, enter. So here it has created draft of 10 degree. And if you want draft on the outward side, then you will have to click here on draft outward. So it will create draft on outward side. And suppose if you don't want this draft, just again click here on this symbol. So it will make it off. Then right now it is open from both the sides. If you want to cover these sides, then you will have to click here on cap end. So it will cover from both the sides. Suppose I want to keep it open. So again by clicking here you can cancel it. Then if you want your extrude on other side, then from here you can reverse direction. Just click on it. It will reverse direction of that extrude. Then if you want to extrude on other side also, then for that you will have to click here inside this box. So it will add this direction to. And here it has created that direction to extrude. Again, here you can specify height for that extrude. Suppose it is 40, enter. Then from here you can again apply draft. Suppose it is 25 degree, enter. And it is required to be outward. Then I want to keep ends open. Then select contours. Right now it is creating interfering extrude. Suppose I want to create extrude of this outside edges. Then for that you will have to use this option, select contours. Using this select contours, you can specify areas which you want to extrude. So you just have to click in the area you want to extrude. So that area will get extrude. So in this way, it will extrude that particular area and it will not extrude these inside curves. Then to accept this extrude, just click here on OK and click outside. So here this extrude is created. From here you can zoom to fit. Then suppose I want to create one limiting curve surface here. Then for that again click here on extruded surface. Then choose your plane. Now here it is not showing any plane. So to view hidden planes, click here on this arrow. And here are the planes. Suppose I want to create that arc on vertical plane, so I will choose this front plane. Then to make it perfectly vertical, click here on sketch 2 and click here on normal 2. So it will be easy to sketch. Then click here on spline, then specify points to create the curve. Then right click and click here on select and click here on back. Then if you want to create extrude on both the sides of your curve, then for that you will have to click here on blind and click here on mid plane. So it will extrude by same distance on both the sides. Suppose I want it to be 150, enter. So I just want to cover this complete shape. So I will increase it further. Suppose I will make it 200, enter. I will just double check by clicking here on top. So here all the shape is covered. Then click here on OK. So here this surface is created. Zoom to fit. Then suppose I want to extrude this surface up to this surface. Then for that you will have to use this extend surface. Click here on extend surface. Then you will have to select edges or faces to extend. Then I want to extend these faces. So just click on them. Then there are three options. You can extend by specifying some distance. So here you will have to specify distance. If you want to extend by distance option. So you can specify distance. If you specify up to point, you will have to specify point. Or by clicking here on up to surface, you can select your surface up to which you want to extend. So I want to extend up to surface. So just select this surface. So here it has been extended up to that surface. Then click here on OK. So here this surface is created. Then suppose I want to remove this outside surface and keep this internal surface only. So to remove unwanted surface, you will have to use trim surface. So click here on trim surface. Then for this, you will have to select trimming surface, plane or sketch. So I want to trim with respect to this surface. So I will select this surface. Then you can either select selections to keep. Suppose if I want to keep this shape, then you directly have to click on that shape, or you can also select selections to remove. So in that case, I will have to select this outside portion. Just click on it, then right click and OK. So here this shape is created. Then suppose I want to show here some circular hole inside this shape. Then for that again I will have to use extruded surface. Click on it, then again click on this arrow to view planes. And suppose I want to create my sketch on this top plane. Then again click here on sketch 3 and click here on normal 2. Then I will create one circle here. Click here on circle. Click on this origin point. Take your cursor away and click. Then click on OK. So here it is creating extruded face. Then there are different options available for end conditions. So up till now we have used this blind option. So just click here. We have also used this mid plane option. Then you can extrude up to body. So right now we don't have any body. Then you can offset from surface. Suppose I choose this option. Then you will have to select one surface for reference. Suppose if I select this surface, then you will have to specify distance. Suppose distance is 20, enter. So here you will see that our extrude is created and this gap is 20. That is offset from surface. So it has left this offset of 20 from this surface. So that is one option. Then if you want to connect to this surface, then you will have to choose this up to surface. And this surface was already selected. So it has taken that automatically. So our extrude is created up to that surface. So it is connecting to that surface. Now our sketch was created on top plane. Suppose I want some gap from this top plane also. Then for that you will have to click here on sketch plane. And you will have to click here on offset. And here you can specify your offset. Suppose I want offset of 30. Enter. So here now my extruded face is getting created with the gap of 30 from our top plane. So in this way you can use different options. Then click here on OK. Click outside. So here this extrude is created. Then again to cut this portion we will have to use trim. So again click here on trim surface. Then click here on this cylinder. And then keep selections. I want to keep this outside portion. And click on OK. So here this hole is created. Then suppose I want to cover this hole from this side. So for that you can use this filled surface. Click here on filled surface. Then you will have to select patch boundary. So you can select this circle. So here it has been filled perfectly. Then click on OK. So here it has been covered perfectly. Then suppose I want to apply fillet to these edges. If I try to create fillet and if I select this surface, so it is giving error. None of the face edges can be filleted. Now this is happening because this is a different surface and this surface is different. So there is no connectivity. So to create that connectivity, we will just cancel it. You will have to use this knit surface. So using this knit surface, you can connect surfaces. So click here on knit surface. Then you will have to select surfaces you want to connect. So I want to connect this surface with this surface and this surface with this surface. And same way, this surface with this cylinder. So I want to connect all these surfaces. Then if you have some gap between these surfaces, you can specify that gap. So this is a knitting tolerance. So up to that gap, it will fill it automatically. If you know that there is no gap, you can remove this tick and click on OK. So now again, we will try that fillet option. Again, click here on fillet. Then select this face. So it has selected it perfectly. But it is not showing any preview of the fillet because fillet value is 10. At your end, if preview is not shown, that means you have not selected this full preview. So I will have to reduce this fillet value. Suppose I will make it 5, enter. So here you will see that it is showing me the preview. Suppose if I make it 7, enter. So again it is not showing preview because after increasing the value, two fillets will get merged. Suppose I will make it 6, enter. So here it is showing the preview. Then click here on OK. So here this fillet is created. Same way you can create fillets on other locations also. Suppose I want fillets here also. Then if you want to convert this model into 3D, then for that we will have to cover this face. So to cover this face, click here on filled surface. And again select these edges, click here on arc face. And we here all the edges and this one. So here it has created this face perfectly. Then click on OK. So here it has covered that portion. So now it is easy to convert this into 3D. So to convert this object into 3D, again you will have to click here on knit surface and select all these surfaces and click here on create solid and click on OK. Now to check whether 3D has been created or not, we will just create one hole. Click here on features, click on extruded cut, then suppose select this face and create one circle. Then right click and exit sketch and then give the depth and click on OK. So here you will see that solid object is created. Therefore this cut got created perfectly. So we have learned some of the basic concept in SolidWorks surfacing. In the next tutorial, we will create one object using these concepts. And if you want to learn complete SolidWorks from very basic level, then complete playlist is given here. So please like, share and subscribe by clicking here on this icon. Thanks for watching. We will again meet in next tutorial.